Hello, and welcome to the second in a series of videos designed to help you become familiar with the EIU Citrix Zen App web interface. In this video, we will be looking at how to navigate to the Citrix Access Gateway and then download the appropriate client software needed to interact with the applications stored on the Citrix server. Let's get started by opening up our web browser and navigating to the EIU Citrix Access Gateway, which is located at eiuapps.cats.eiu.edu. Here, go ahead and put in your appropriate username and password, and press the logon button. Here, we are presented with a page that lets us know that we need the appropriate client software enabled to work with the applications on the Citrix server. To download the first of two software applications, press this checkbox and then notice that the download button becomes active after selecting the checkbox. So go ahead and press the download button, and it will ask us if we want to run or save this file. Let's go ahead and press save, and it's going to ask us where do we want to save this file. I'm going to go ahead and navigate to the desktop, which is right here, so I can easily find it, and then I'll press save, and it shouldn't take too long to download, and there it is, pops up on my desktop. So I'm going to go ahead and close out of this window for a moment and then start the installation progress and press run, and this should only take a few seconds to complete. It's not a very complicated process, and there we are. We are informed that the installation was completed successfully. So let's go ahead and press close and reopen our internet browser and return to the Citrix Access Gateway. And log back in again. And here we are presented again with the same page, but we don't need to download it again because we have already installed it. So let's go ahead and press this option here that says already installed. Now we are only halfway finished with installing software. We need to go here to the messages tab. Notice that there is an orange triangle with an exclamation point in it. So let's go ahead and press on the messages tab. And here under the information box, it says the website is unable to detect the appropriate client software on your computer, so we will not be able to access our published resources. So let's go ahead and click on this link down here. And we don't have to select the checkbox in this case, so let's just go ahead and press download. Again, let's press save. And in the same spot where I downloaded the other client software, I'll just go ahead and press save again. And it should download to my desktop. And there it is. And again, I'm going to go ahead and close out of my browser for a moment and start installing this other piece of software by pressing run. And English is the default language, so I'll just go ahead and press OK. And you can read through this if you want, but it's a pretty standard installation, so I'll just go ahead and press next. And it's a very short license agreement, so don't really need to go into too much detail with that. I'll just go ahead and press accept and next. This is the default location to save this program, so I'll just go ahead and leave it as it is and press install. And here we are notified that the installation has completed successfully, so let's go ahead and press finish. And there's another little piece of software that needs to install before we can open up our web browser again, so I'll go ahead and wait for that to finish. And there we are. The other piece of software is completed. So now we can go ahead and open up our internet browser again. And we are informed that we must restart our system for the installation to complete. So I'm going to go ahead and take a break here and restart my computer, and I'll see you when I get back. Now that we have finished restarting our computer, we are ready to finally start using the applications stored on the Citrix server. To do so, we need to log into the Citrix Access Gateway by opening up our web browser and navigating to eiuapps.cats.eiu.edu and then logging in with our appropriate username and password. Here we are presented with a list of applications that are available to us. To start an application, simply click on the icon that you wish to use only one time. We will be going over how to save and interact with documents in a later video. If you have any questions, feel free to call the CATS office or the ITS help desk, both of which will be happy to assist you in using the Citrix server. Thank you.